Good morning, everybody. Excuse me for looking so beautiful. It's about 7:15 in the morning. Just got my kid on the bus to school, and my husband was out the door at 7. It's raining here, and I feel pretty certain I'm going to have to take a change of shoes and possibly pants up to the school, because out in front of our house there's like a ditch, and it's just, with the rain that we got all during the night, it's just filled up really, really high. And I saw through the headlights of the other cars behind the bus, because the bus stops like right in front of our house, and I saw in the headlights when my son went down into the ditch to get to the bus, there's like a big splash of water. So, and I heard the bus driver say, "Did you get wet?" And I don't know what my son says. So I'm like, "No," or something, which, you know, dang well he got his feet wet. And I don't want him, you know, to have to wear wet socks and shoes, you know, all day at school when I'm, you know, not even, I'm barely a mile down the road from the school, and I could take it to him. I may call up there and have them ask if he's okay or not, you know, with that, because I don't mind taking that and dropping it off if that's the case. But I'm just doing a little Facebooking, whatever you call it. I had to do, had the camera going the wrong way. I had to do a big update last night and had my laptop open because, I mean, now that we've got we had Windows 8.1 earlier till, what was it, last year, they introduced Windows 10. And now there's some kind of update called Windows 10 Home. I don't know what that's all about. I need to go turn the porch light off. I can see that it's on out there. So, I'm not doing my grocery shopping today. Just a minute, it's going to be a little bit dark. Turn that light off. I'm not going to do my grocery shopping today, but I am going to have to go to the, like, Walmart or something. Probably the close one, like the neighborhood Walmart. You know, it's the one that doesn't have, like, the main store stuff in it, just groceries. Because yesterday I forgot to buy broccoli for the beef and broccoli stir fry. I don't know what I was thinking about not getting broccoli. And we had that nacho hamburger helper, nacho supreme, or no, a Fiesta nacho hamburger helper last night. It was okay. It was a little on the spicy side. If you have kids, I would not recommend it. My kids, if my six-year-old wasn't such a picky eater, because he won't, I mean, he'll eat cheeseburgers from McDonald's, but yeah, he won't eat the hamburger and hamburger helper. If it wasn't for the fact that he's a picky eater, and I didn't make him eat that, I made him something different, actually, for once. Normally, I make him eat what we eat. There's no way he could have eat that. It's way too spicy. My husband even thought it was way too spicy. And I won't be buying that again. I mean, it had a good taste, but unless you like spicy stuff, then by all means, go for it. It's for you. But it wasn't for my family. So that's how that went. But anyway, so back to this computer thing. I had to let it do update all night long. And then at like 3:35, I was in here messing around with it, and it had finally quit and restarted and all that stuff. And then my one-year-old woke up, wanted something to drink, needed a diaper change and all that kind of groovy motherly stuff. But, so yeah, I need to vacuum this house today. And I really need to get it mopped. And when I say mop, I don't use a mop. I use a steam mop. Those things, if you've never used a steam mop, will save your life. And you'll get a good workout, too. Because it sanitizes and everything. You can. It's even got like a... The one I have is made by Hoover? Yeah. I'll probably show you guys in a little while when I do it. But the bottom reservoir, you put water in, and sometimes I'll put like a part water, part vinegar, and then the top part is got a solution that you put in there that's made just for the machine, like if you want to do an extra good cleaning on hardwood floors. But this one will do hardwood floors and like laminate and linoleum and tile and grout, and just it comes with like 12 different attachments, and you can like take it apart, like pop out like the little portable part of it and take it out to your car if you wanted to. I do that to like go around the toilets if I really want to get the toilets, you know, mom with boys and a man in the house, get them, you know, good and clean with that steamer. I definitely recommend this one. And I use that thing several times, usually a day, but the last couple of days I didn't, because I did everything right before Thanksgiving, and I just kind of took a lazy couple of days after that, because my husband was home. We were all just had Redbox movies going on and eating leftovers and just, you know, whatever. But it's time to put the house back together, so I've got to definitely do that, because my one-year-old is in the stage of when he's eaten, if he's done eating whatever you give him, he throws it to the floor. And I get that picked up, get any crumbs, you know, swept up or whatever. And if it's something sticky like peanut butter and jelly, oh Lord, or waffle with syrup on it or something, I wipe that up. But that good old steam mop, boy, it'll come in and just really just freshen everything up. Makes the house smell better, just all around. I can't just praise that thing enough. So yeah, I gotta do that. And I got just a small load of laundry to do, should I choose to do it. It's not nothing necessary, because I did a lot yesterday. But yeah, that's really all. Just a few dishes in the sink. And I kind of don't really, you know, want to have to go anywhere with this rain, but I'm going to have to in order to do dinner tonight, because there's nothing else really to make. And I've got some chicken tenders in there, but I really won't want chicken after we just had Thanksgiving dinner and leftovers. I'll catch back up with you in a little while. Yeah, a little while. Okay, so I got my shower, and I thought I'd show you what I'm wearing today. It's just this t-shirt from a few years ago. Well, for me, because one of my sister-in-laws gave it to me. It has snowflakes, little embroidered designs all over it, and I like it this time of year. The most important thing was I got my shower out of the way, and I got the bed made. Yay! Over here I got some gifts for all our nieces and nephews. And in my closet, golly, my closet needs help. I got a dresser in here to save room, because I like getting dressed in my closet. But that's for my six-year-old. That's the stuff that, you know, Santa leaves for you. Supposed to. That's how we did it when I was growing up. But anyway, and then over here, yeah, our room's so big we have a couch in it. That's for my one-year-old, you know, that Santa leaves out. It's got a couple of pajamas and Paw Patrol stuff, and then some more wrapping paper stuff in case my husband decides out of the goodness of his heart he needs to wrap me something. So I need to get my tennis shoes on and get Levi fed, some cereal or something, and get on out the door. Get on with this day. Okay, so I'm in the car now. I need to go stop by my son's school. And it turns out he did get his feet wet pretty good. The teacher didn't know about the pants, so I'm going to take pants, socks, and shoes to him. And then be on my way to the store. So I got up here to the school, and I parked up front like I owned the place. And let me pull over here for a second and tell you what I'm about to do. My son, okay, he didn't need, his pant leg was a little wet, but it wasn't wet enough that he felt he needed to change the pants. He changed into the shoes and socks after constant coaching from the teacher and from me. Hurry up, buddy. Hurry up. You got class. You got to do this. You got to do that. And this is the first time I've ever met with his teacher since we've moved over to this area where we are now, because he had to change schools. And anyway, I sent her an email this morning, and evidently she didn't get it. She got it after she checked it, I think. I sent the email. I think that's how it went. Well, my son has ADHD, amongst other things, and we've only discovered this during the past year, and we've been constantly trying different medicines and stuff, and I hate even having him on medicine. I've always been totally against that, but anyway, she said she had to get on to him this morning because
he picked up the little yellow thing, which I think it's a like a mint or whatever for a urinal. He picked that up and then didn't want to wash his hands. And she finally got him to wash his hands. And I mean, he knows about washing his hands because we practice this at home. We're constantly telling him, did you wash your hands after you flush the toilet? And you know, blah, blah, blah. And so, yeah. And so she asked me, you know, one of the things was he had changed medicines. He was on a generic form of Ritalin, which is called Metadate or Methylphenidate, is like the generic terms for that. And insurance finally allowed for a long release where he didn't have to take pills at home, and then at school he could just take one pill at home for the whole day amongst whatever else he's already taking in the mornings. And anyway, they put him on Concerta, and the insurance only would pay for the generics. I had to get it pushed through with the doctor, filling out forms and faxing and all this kind of stuff. And then, you know, I get to actually pick the prescription up tomorrow, actually, the 3rd. Today's second day of Vlogmas, by the way. Throw that out there before I forget. So, anyway, she asked me, had I heard anything on it? And I'm like, you didn't get my email, you know? And so, and my hair looks whack. Somebody's coming by. Anyway, so yeah, I explained to her what I basically just told you, that yeah, he'll get to take it tomorrow. I'll get to pick it up. Walgreens was trying to say it's too soon because I dropped it off last Friday. They said, or maybe it was Thursday. They said, no, it's too soon. The soonest you can get it is December 3rd. I'm like, he didn't even have this before. Y'all filled the generic because, you know, I don't even understand the thing. So I'm rambling. It's just, you know, dealing with a child with ADHD and autism issues and what is it called? Asperger's. My son has this thing where he, when he goes to sleep, he will bang his head and rock and hum and just this hand flapping thing he does when he's real excited about something. And that was the first thing I noticed. And when he was really small, like the size or younger than my 1-year-old now, it took all I could do to get that baby to smile. And he was just never really, I don't know, he was never clingy to me or nothing like that. I just knew something was different. And then from the moment he could lift his head up, he would bang it in on his mattress, like to go to sleep. I mean, he did it at a daycare one time on the floor, like the hard floor. I mean, I had to always warn people, he's going to do this, this is it. And I guess I was in denial that he was even had anything wrong going on or whatever. So I think it's called arrhythmic, I forget what the whole acronym thing is. But anyway, I actually applied for, what is it, SSI, like a disability thing to help get him some, like, maybe therapy or something, because he has a whole sensory disorder. I mean, like, he's funny about eating certain foods with certain textures. Like I was telling you about earlier, the hamburger meat issue. Like, if it's, like, big old thick patties grilled, he won't eat that. But if it's McDonald's or Burger King hamburgers, he'll eat those. He likes Hardee's, but anything, like, coarse hamburger like you would have. I mean, I can barely get him to eat tacos. I've just gotten to where now he'll actually try and eat the tacos, but he'll, you know, eventually he'll scratch some of that hamburger meat off, the taco meat. So it's just, oh my gosh, I've never had a kid that I had to deal with this before, so this is the first time, so feel sorry for me. I try to understand and be as loving as I can and supportive of him and things like that, and it is raining. That's why my hair looks whack, in case I didn't say that already. So I'm heading to that Walmart, the closest one, that little neighborhood Walmart that opened up over here end of October. So that's where I'm trying to get to. See, y'all, I was not lying when I said it's nasty outside and raining. So, I'm going to go in this store. I'm going to try to get me a front row parking spot, like over there near that black awning to the right down there. Well, shoot, them people are parked over there. I don't know, I might can get in there. Next to that little red car, that's actually where I parked yesterday. I was actually here yesterday, too. Yeah, they're doing, well, they park all over the place. Well, I'm going to park all over the place, too. So, oh, goodness. Let's get in there and try not to get too wet. Okay, I'm back home, and real quick, I got some milk, I got some apple juice, I needed some more cornstarch. I wanted a small thing, but this is all I had. Some broccoli to do the stir fry, the beef and broccoli stir fry tonight. And I thought I might do some chocolate chip cookies. I got a half a bag of like Nestle chocolate chips and some M&M's, but I don't think it'd be quite enough. So I read the ingredients between these and the Nestle, and they look pretty close to the same. So yeah, I'm gonna probably make some chocolate chip cookies and then maybe freeze some of the dough or something, or I don't know. And Levi's in here. You're having a snack. Oh, having a snack? Some puffs? Yeah. So I've got a bunch of dishes over here to do, some to put away and some to wash and put these groceries away. Got a little bit of pumpkin pie in here. Need to do, this is a turkey pot pie that I made the other day. This has got the stir fry beef I need to use. What else? That's buttermilk I need to do something with. Look at this big old thing. I haven't even opened this yet. This is the biggest one that I could find. So yeah. Now, one thing I hate about this refrigerator is you have to put your milk either here. Like, if I go get this full thing of tea out, you have to, like, it's like hard to get in and out of there. It will not fit in here, like where it should. This is like tipped back to like even go in there. Let me show you what I'm at. My son puts his drinks where he wants them. See, like, move that. And it definitely won't fit up here. Now, like, see, if I wanted this to go here, I have to tip it back to make it fit. Isn't that crazy? That's just crazy. And this thing of juice will have to just lay down for right now. Levi's in there having his snack. This is my son's drawer for lunch. It needs to be replenished. This is juices. This is all the go-gurts he's got left. A couple of go-go squeeze kind of things here. And he's got behind there are those, let me just show you. I just stick them in here. Those little breakfast drinks, because his doctor says he needs, like, to have, because he's so skinny from that ADHD medicine he takes, it makes him not want to eat, and he's already a picky eater. So I give him those. They're like what they call the poor man's version of, he wants me to shut the door. What is that drink called? Boost or something? One of them, it ain't Pedialyte. One of them kid drinks. Pediasure. So yeah. So I get those for him to help him kind of get more protein and calories in and everything, because he runs around and burns off a lot of calories, plus because he's so hyper. But anyway, that's it for now, and hopefully I will be able to finish this vlog, because I know it's already going to be long, and this is probably the most boringest vlog. I say Vlogmas vlog that you've ever watched by me anyway. Okay, y'all, I hope y'all enjoyed coming along with me today on this vlog. I hope it's not too long. Tomorrow might be a little bit different. I might be doing like a longer, when I say longer, I mean like skip forward in my day some and let you see what it's like after my six-year-old gets home, or, you know, that kind of thing. Kind of change it up a bit. So I'll see you tomorrow for Vlogmas Day number 3.